What's up, Mark from Wandering Souls, back with a new video, a new update, a CD update this time, not really big, only three to show you, some black metal and some death metal. Let's start off with the black metal. First album I've got new in my collection is Funeral Winds with Nexion Skull, The Cursed Bloodline, which is this album. Their third album, released by Shadowlust. Inside, and this is some really gnarly black metal from the Netherlands in the Rotterdam area. Third album, like I said, was released in 2007. Yeah, then the band releases only four albums, and they tend to take a lot of time to release an album because the follow-up to this one came out in 2018, so that's 11 years, so that's pretty long. And prior to this, the other one, I think, was 4 or 5 years or something, I don't know, maybe longer. And then there was a couple of years before that. Really nice black metal, raw, straight, old school black metal. Definitely not really surprising, but they are from the old school area, so only they take a lot of time to release stuff. I also have a lot of split EP from this band and maybe another album, I don't know, but yeah, really glad that I found this for really cheap, and I thought, let's buy this one. Really nice album, Funeral Winds with Nexion Skull, The Cursed Bloodline. Next up, an album from Behexen from Finland, if I'm not mistaken, is Rituale Satanam. Really nice cult black metal. This album definitely does not sound like the last album, Poisonous Path. This is some way more raw, no clean vocals, way more satanic. Yeah, pretty different than the last album they have released. If you like more raw stuff, then this is definitely more up your alley than the latest album. Not that the latest album is not black metal, of course it's a black metal, but yeah, this is some other kind of shit that that album. Really nice album, this one. I know there's a one limited edition in this one from this label and from other reissues. There are also some other reissues from other labels, but from this label there are two issues, a limited one and just a straight one. I don't know exactly which version this is. I'm assuming this is the regular version. Yeah, but the original version, the limited version, is limited to 500 copies, and it goes for a pretty big bucks on Discogs. So I really want to know, is this the regular version, or let's see the barcode here, or the limited version? I can't tell. Everything is the same, but it doesn't state it anywhere that it's the, I probably can't see it here, the limited version, but the matrix code, the barcodes, everything is the same, but I can't tell if this is, because Discogs doesn't say what the difference between those two are. If it's a limited edition, probably not, probably the other one, then I scored really big time, because I only paid 5 euros for this, and the thing is worth on Discogs like 150 euro. So that's a pretty big difference, like I said, but this though is This cox is probably 15 euros or something, the regular version. Then, of course, I scored because I make a profit of 10 euros. But you know, I can tell this is a 2000 issue and the other one as well. So, yeah, guys, if you know the difference of those two versions, please tell me. Then I know exactly which version I have now. I assuming that's a cheaper version, but I know don't know really for sure. So let me know, guys, how do I see that it's that version? Because the rest, the barcode, the like I said, matrix code, this code here on the side is all, but all both versions are the same. So cover is the same, in the layout is the same. So I don't know what exactly the difference is. Please let me know if you know it. Anyways, BXM with Rituala Satanam, a really nice raw black metal, some ritualistic things in there here as well. Logo is done by Crystal Spradle. This logo, although that's a Belgium artist, it's he does a lot of other logos in black metal land, Jericho, Marduk, etc., etc. A lot of other stuff. Anyways, really like this album. Definitely one of my gems in my collection, black metal wise, and yeah, I really enjoy it. So, good stuff. And the last one is a death metal album, filling a gap in my collection for this band. I had it on CDR, but I thought let's replace it. I found this pretty cheap, so let's replace it with this original version. Anyways, limited. I don't know. Anyways, this is Digipack, released by Eric. This is Hate Eternal King of All Kings, their 2002 release, second album. Really, really nice death metal. Good drum work by Derek Ruddy. Really amazing stuff. I'm really glad to own this in my collection now. Jared Addison was also still in the band. Of course, he's passed away a couple years later. great stuff. Hate Eternal, King of All Kings. If you don't have it, go check it out. Definitely worth checking. Great stuff. That's it, guys. Really short, I know. I'm still waiting for some vinyl to do a video for that, for a vinyl update. Of course, there will be a new playlist of the week video, probably Saturday or something. I don't know, maybe Sunday. Anyway, in that area. Let me know what you think of those releases, guys, and definitely know. Let me know what the difference is for the Behexen CD. Do I have the a regular version from that label or the limited version? What's the difference? I want to know really bad. Then I really can check out that on Discogs from that for sure. That version I have. Anyways, thank you for watching, liking, and supporting. If you want to see more, subscribe to my channel. I really would appreciate that. And hope to see you guys next time, next video. Have a good one.